So for the today's flight, the pilot is Shruti, co-pilot is Manbir, and the crew member is Imrani. So for over to you, Shruti.
Yes, thank you, Manbir. So everyone is excited to visit Nepal?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Is the screen visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
So let's first talk about where Nepal is actually located. So Nepal is located between India and this is China, and Nepal lies between these two. China is at this north of Nepal, and the southern slopes of the Nepal is the mountain ranges, Himalayan mountains that lies here. So this country is known as the landlocked country because it is surrounded from the countries, the two countries, India and China, from both the sides. And the length from this, like from west to east, it's around 800 miles only. So 800 kilometers, the country is around 800 kilometers from north to south.
Miss?
Yes.
Which country are we going to learn tomorrow?
For tomorrow, we are going to New Zealand. New Zealand.
Can you know the spelling of that?
Can you talk about it after the session, please? So, do you see this area? This is called Siliguri Valley, which connects, this is Bangladesh and this is Nepal. This area, this small corridor, this is known as Siliguri Corridor, and this connects Nepal from Bangladesh. Now, this is the map of Nepal. This shows that the most of the areas of Nepal is covered with mountains. Like 75% of the entire country is covered with mountains. This area you see, this gray area and this green area, these areas are mountains. The lower part, so the country is divided into four main physical belts. So first, this is the lower yellow part. This is known as, this part is known as Tarai. Okay, this is the flat fertile land, and the next, this is the orange part. This part is known as forested Churai foothills, because from here the mountain starts. So now this green part is known as mid mountain region, and the last, the gray part, this is known as the Great Himalayan Range. And ma'am, this range is, yes?
It is the physical belts annotation, ma'am. I did it for you to know. Please address it.
Okay.
Can you erase it?
Just a
second. Okay, ma'am, erase it. It's disturbance. That's all.
And So this gray part is known as the mountains, Himalayan range. This comes under the Himalayan range. And the height or the total height of these areas is around 8,850 maximum, which is the Mount Everest, which belongs to Nepal. Next is, we'll talk about the national flag. So this is the only country which do not have a quadrilateral flag. All the flags of every country has a quadrilateral flag, but this country has a non-quadrilateral flag with two pennants, and has a moon and a moon with a sun. So this moon with the sun, it symbolizes about the pleasant weather of the Himalayas, and the sun symbolizes the heat and the higher temperatures in the lower lining areas of the Nepal. Now, do you know the capital of Nepal? Can anyone tell me what capital of Nepal? Okay. So capital of Nepal is Kathmandu, and it is
Kathmandu.
So the Kathmandu is the biggest city of Nepal, and it is like, did you see the shape of Kathmandu? It is in a bowl shape. So it is called the bowl shape valley, in which is located at the center of the Nepal. Next, talking about the government of Nepal. So till 2008, the government is the Nepal had a king, and the government is known as the His Majesty's government. But after 2008, they moved to democracy, and now they are having a prime minister and a president as India has. So do you know the president of Nepal? The name of the president of Nepal? Anyone?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So president is Vidya Devi Bhandari, and prime minister, anyone? Prime minister, name of the prime minister of Nepal?
K.P. Sharma Oli.
Right. So it's K.P. Sharma Oli. Next, the currency. This is the currency of Nepal. They have, they call it rupiah. Nepali rupiah, it's called. So do you know how much is 1 rupee in Nepali currency? Indian 1 rupee in Nepali currency.
Ma'am, I know.
Yes, please.
1.63 rupees.
Yes, so 1 Indian rupee is equals to 1.60 Nepali rupees. And these are their coins they use. This is 1 rupee coin, and this is a 2 rupee coin. So they have this mountain range, because all the Nepal areas is covered with mountains. So they use this mountain ranges to symbolize their coins and the country. Now, talking about the language of Nepal. So mostly the spoken language is Nepali. Then the second largest language spoken is Maithili. Maithili is spoken because previously some of the parts of Nepal, the lower parts, comes under India, and the area which covered by the Indian territory, that was known as Maithili. Those people speak Maithili. So majority, like 11.7% people speak Maithili there. Then other languages they spoke are Bhojpuri, Tharu, Thamang, Mangar, Urdu, and so on. So the alphabets they use in their Nepali, speaking Nepali and writing Nepali, is same as ours.
Do you know? They speak English?
Yes, they speak English, but it's not like much spoken in their country.
Okay, ma'am. Only for guides.
Yeah. Because English is a standard language for all over the world, so everyone has to learn, but they are not much familiar with English.
Okay, ma'am. If someone is talking English, they can talk.
Yes.
Like that, ma'am.
Yes, yes. Because Nepal is...
Can you show the Nepalian letters?
They use the same letters what we use. You know this ka kha ga ga?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, I know this all already, ma'am. Because this is all Hindi, ma'am.
Yes, yes. So they use the Hindi alphabet for the Nepali language as well. Okay.
I'm a Hindi student, ma'am. The second language is Hindi, so I know a half about it.
Good, good. So we all have learned Hindi in our lower grades. I'm sure everyone knows this ka kha ga ga.
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
Yes, ma'am.
Ka kha ga ga na cha 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 ja na.
Ma'am, okay,
okay. Now I know everyone knows. That's very good. Now please mute everyone so I can proceed. Yeah. So next is about their religion. Since most of the parts they share their boundaries, Nepal share their boundaries with India. So 81% are Hindu in their country. Then 9% is Buddhism. The area covered, the shared with the Chinese boundary, most of the people there are Buddhist. And then they have 4.4% Islamic in their country. Next 3.0% is Kiritis, 1.4% is Christian, and other religions are Sikhs and Jain. And there are many other religions because it's a secular country. So they have a lot, many religions situated in their valleys. Next, talking about their festivals. So Nepal has mainly 50 festivals, like total festivals in their each small areas, or if you talk about each small states in the country, each state has many festivals. They celebrate according to the fest, according to weather, according to their history, or something like that. So the main festival that they celebrate in the whole Nepal is, first is the Krishna Puja, that we also celebrate similar to that. Next is Dashain and Tihar. You know Durga Puja in our country, as we celebrate Durga Puja, they celebrate Dashain. The Dashain is similar to Durga Puja. They celebrate it for 15 days. But like we celebrate for 10 days, but they celebrate it for 15 days. And they do the same all. How we worship Ma Durga, and then we all the things that we do in Durga Puja, similar is there this festival Dashain. The next festival that is very very much celebrated is Buddha Jayanti. Since the country has a large population of
Buddhists, it happens in China every time.
Yeah, so a large area of boundary is connected with China, so they celebrate. So many people are Buddhist in the country, so they also celebrate Buddha Jayanti there. Next, these are their folk dances and traditional dances they follow. This is Ghatu Nritya, this is Lakhi dance, and this is Maruni. These are some of the famous dances or traditional forms of dance that, yes?
Ma'am, I know Maruni dance.
Very good. You see this this person wearing this mask. So Lakhi, believe that Lakhi
dance. Can you tell something about Lakhi dance?
Okay, so Lakhi dance, they think that Lakhi is, yes?
Can I tell something about Lakhi dance?
Yes, please.
In Lakhi dance, people wear mask and dance.
Yes, they wear mask because they treat Lakhi as an evil who is trying to get to their territory or rule on people and kill good people. So they, just to celebrate that occasion winning from the evil, they do this dance. Next.
It's to save good people, no?
Yes, yes. So now do you know this animal? I hope everyone knows this animal.
A cow.
It's a cow.
Cow.
So their national animal is cow. Then this is their national bird. Anyone knows its name?
I think it's a peacock.
No, it's not a peacock.
It looks like a peacock, but...
No, it's not.
Ma'am, it just starts with I letter, right?
No.
Ma'am, can you tell a clue?
It's found in the Himalayan region only.
What is the first letter?
Ma'am, Himalayan Mona.
I think so. The first letter is I, right?
Himalayan Mona.
Yes, yes. So the name of this bird is Himalayan Monal. So this is their national bird.
It looks like a rainbow.
Yeah, it's beautiful. It
looks like a peacock. It looks like a peacock.
Yeah, it looks like a peacock, but it's not a peacock. So this is their national flower. This is their
national flower. It's like a hibiscus.
It's a hibiscus.
No, it's not a hibiscus. It's a type of hibiscus, but not... it belongs to the same family, biological family.
Pink
so
hibiscus?
No. It's known as Rhododendron. Dendron. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Next, this is their cuisines.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Time late.
Okay, so anyone knows the national dish of Nepal?
Ma'am, that fourth photo, is it Modak or is it Momos?
It's Momos. They have a very good Momos there in Nepal.
Ma'am, the Nepal food is similar to Indian food.
Yes, yes, very similar to Indian food, and their national food is known as Gundro. You see this green veggie here? This is known as Gundro. Okay, it's a pickle, vegetable pickle type of food they make. So next, so Nepal, even if it's a very small country, it has many world records. It holds a lot of records in their name. So the first record that they hold is the Mount Everest. The Mount Everest is the highest peak in the entire world. And the height is around 8,848 meters. Next they have is Poksundo Lake. And this is the deepest lake in the world. And it is around 145 meter in depth. And the third world record they have is Arun Valley. So this place is the highest valley on the earth. So you see how like even if it's a small country, they have such beautiful places to visit. Now talking about the airlines of the country, so the main airline they have is known as the Nepal Airlines. Do you see the flag? They have similar symbols on their airplane as their airplane logo also. So this is their national airlines. Next, they have two other airlines, major airlines, that is international airlines. One is the Buddha Air. Buddha Air is a very good, like very different type of airline. It's very beautiful to look and different from the normal airlines. Then they have Himalayan Airlines as a international airlines. Next, there are some very good places to visit in Nepal. So I have a video for you. That shows you the different places that you can visit Nepal. So just a minute.
Ma'am, I have seen and take a photo by a Buddha, ma'am.
Okay. So this place is known as the birthplace of Gautam Buddha.
This. So can I see?
What do you want me to do?
I am telling that there is very rainy.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, it's really raining very heavily, and I think there's a very big issue of network here.
So probably maybe
she might leave the meeting.
Oh, that's okay. We will share the video with you so you can watch afterwards.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
So this is the Mount Everest. People like professional trekkers who have a large years of experience go for trekking to these mountains.
You want to climb?
Yes, I cannot hear you.
Ma'am, can anybody climb to the edge?
Yes, many people has climbed to Everest. Many people has been there to the top of the mountain, and the first person that went to first person to be there and to the top of the Everest was Edmund Hillary. He was the first person to climb Mount Everest. He was from New Zealand.
Then I will go there with my mother, father, and my grandmother.
Sure. So if you don't want to climb the mountain, you can come to this place and watch all the mountain ranges. Okay. For their all the hobbies like cycling and all and racing cars, it's a very good place, and the climate and the atmosphere for climbing and cycling and car racing is very prompt at that place. Your trip to Nepal?
Yes, ma'am, a lot.
That's great if you enjoyed. So anyone has any other questions about Nepal?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am, I don't have a question. I want to tell something.
Yes, please, Nisa.
Ma'am, Sita was, when she was in the forest, Sita was kidnapped by Ravan, and Hanuman ji came to save her with the Ram, Lord Ram's ring.
Yes, right. Correct.
Because when it used to come, you know, on the TV, Ramayan, last year. So oh, I used to watch it in my family.
Very good, very good. So, who wants to present today? I think I received 2 PPTs. Sasha. Okay, anyone else want to present today?
Ma'am, I want to.
Okay, Riddhi. So,
I want to present tomorrow.
Okay, okay. So, just a minute. Yes?
Actually, you have to make me the co-host for presenting.
Yes, yes. Wait, I'll make you the co-host. Yes, Sasha, you are the co-host now, so you can present your PPT to us.
Yes. Good afternoon, one and all present here. Today, I'm Sasha D'Souza, and I'm going to share my PPT about Nepal, the history of Nepal. The history of Nepal is intertwined with the history of the broader Indian subcontinent and the surrounding regions comprising the areas of South Asia and East Asia. Nepal is a multi-ethnic, multi-racial, multicultural, multi-religious, and multilingual country. The most spoken language is Nepali, followed by several other ethnic languages. The Kingdom of Nepal was established in 1768 and started a campaign of unifying all of Nepal that would form modern territories of Nepal. Some former territories had been lost due to the kingdom having participated in the Sino-Nepalese War, which ended in both victory and losses, ultimately accepting as a tribute state of the Qing dynasty of China from 1792 to 1865. The Anglo-Nepalese War ended in British victory and ceded some Nepalese territory. In a historical vote for the election of the Constituent Assembly, the Nepalese Parliament voted to abolish the monarchy in June 2006. Nepal became a federal republic on 28 May 2008 and was formally renamed the Federal Democratic Republic of Nepal, ending in 200-year-old reign of the Shah monarchs. The capital, population, area, and location of Nepal. Capital of Nepal is Kathmandu. Population of Nepal, 29.2 million. Area of Nepal, 147,181 square kilometers, approximately
56,826.90 square miles, located in the Asian continent. The currency of Nepal. The currency of Nepal is called as Nepalese rupee. This is the Nepalese note and this is the Nepalese coin. The royal family of Nepal. The royal family of Nepal is called as Nepalese royal massacre. This is the picture of the royal family. The president and prime minister of Nepal. The president of Nepal is Bidya Devi Bhandari and the prime minister is K.P. Sharma Oli. The flag of Nepal. The national flag of Nepal is the world's only non-quadrilateral flag that acts as both the state flag and civil flag of a sovereign country. The flag is a simplified combination of two single pennants known as a double pennant. It was adopted on 16th December 1962. The national emblem of Nepal. The emblem of Nepal was changed during the reconciliation period following the Nepalese civil war. It was adopted on 28th of May 2008. The religion of Nepal. Hinduism is a dominant religion, given that Nepal was the birthplace of Buddha, as well as the world's only Hindu kingdom. Nepal is an important place for many Hindus and Buddhists. This is the chart of religion of Nepal. 81.3% Hindu, 9% of Buddhist, 4.4% Muslim, 3.1% Kirat, that is the local traditional belief, 1.4% Christianity, and 0.8% are the other religions of Nepal. The culture of Nepal. The culture of Nepal encompasses the various cultures belonging to the 125 distinct ethnic groups present in Nepal. The culture of Nepal is expressed through music, dance, art and craft, folklore, languages and literature, philosophy and religions, festivals and celebration, which includes food and drinks. The national flower of Nepal. Nepal's national flower, rhododendron, are found in the altitude range from 1200 meters to 3600 meters above the sea level. The national airline of Nepal. The national airline of Nepal is called as Nepal Airlines Corporation, which was founded on 1st July 1958, 62 years ago, as Royal. Secondary hubs are Biratnagar Airport, Nepal Gunj. Headquarters, Kantipat, Kathmandu, Bagmati. Hubs, Tribhuvan International Airport. The national language of Nepal. Nepali language, also called as Gurkha, Gorkhali, or Gurkhali, or Khaskura, member of the Pahari subgroup of the Indo-Aryan group of the Indo-Iranian division of the Indo-European languages. Nepali is spoken by more than 17 million people, mostly in Nepal and neighboring parts of India. The clothing of Nepal. The traditional male dress, which is also the national dress, is the Nepali shirt called Dora and Suruval. The woman's traditional costume of Nepal is called as Kurta Suruval. It consists of big, light, baggy pants, a blouse, and a large scarf. The national sport of Nepal. Volleyball was declared the national sport of Nepal on 23rd May 2017. food in Nepal. Dal bhat. Dal bhat is one of the most basic dishes of Nepali cuisine. The Newa cuisine. The Newas were the first inhabitants of the Kathmandu Valley. And momos. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Sasha. You can stop Sacha. Sharing. This was a very beautiful reading. Yes.
Yes, Tanvi. Tomorrow, can I present the screen of New Zealand?
Yes, yes, you can.
Miss, before Tanvi, I am.
Ma'am, should I present now?
Miss,
before
yes,
Tanvi, really. I am. Ma'am, can I present if I can do?
Hi, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am, I'm presenting.
Okay. We cannot have everyone. So please send us your PPT so we can decide who
Sasha,
can.
Sasha, okay?
Ma'am, can you pardon, please?
Like
yes.
You.
Yes, Riddhi, you can present.
Thank you.
Ma'am, can you see?
Miss?
Excuse me, ma'am.
How do I send my PPT?
Please, everyone on mute. Let Riddhi present, then I'll tell you how you can send.
Ma'am.
Yes.
If I can do the presentation on tomorrow, I will do, ma'am. But in web WhatsApp, I cannot send it, ma'am, because I have issues in my laptop. Little.
Ma'am?
Okay, so if we have time, we can have yours also. Yes, Riddhi.
Can you see my screen?
No, we cannot see your screen.
Okay, ma'am, wait.
Okay, so also I have an announcement to make for all of the guests. All of those who are interested to make presentations, please make sure you should put less content and more images. Anyone who is interested in making presentations for tomorrow or for the coming days, make sure it should not be lengthy. It should consist of less content and more images. I hope I am clear to everyone.
Ma'am, can you little tell it loudly because I cannot hear you.
Okay, so I am telling to put less content in the presentation and more images to your PPT. It should not be lengthy.
Ma'am, can I this is a Nepal map. The neighboring countries are China and India. This is Nepali rupee. These are the Nepali rupees. This is the capital of Nepal, Kathmandu. As you can see, this Nepal's traditional dress, Daura. Nepal's national bird is Himalayan Monal, and Nepal's national animal is cow. Prime Minister is KP Sharma Oli, and President is Vidya Devi Bhandari. Nepal's traditional food, it's very similar to Indian food. There is bhat as boiled rice. This is dal, lentil soup, and many other things like salad, achar, pickle, like that. Population of Nepal is 29.2 million. Area is 14,07,560 km². And Nepalese 1 rupee is equal to 0.60 rupee, Indian rupee. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Riddhi. Your PPT was very beautiful.
It was nice. I like it. Riddhi.
So that's all for today. Let's meet tomorrow with a new country, New Zealand. I hope you enjoyed everything about Nepal.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Yes, ma'am.
See you.
Yes, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.